Microsoft just launched Miko, an emotional AI orb that lives inside Copilot, and it's basically Clippy's revenge arc. This glowing sphere reacts to your tone, remembers your conversations, and genuinely changes expression while you're talking. It blinks. It smiles. It even tilts when you sound confused. And somehow, it's not creepy. It's actually useful. The rollout started quietly a few months back, but now it's going live by default across the United States. Miko isn't just a chatbot with a face. It's tied directly into Copilot's new memory system, which means it knows what projects you're working on, what questions you asked last week, and what you're trying to accomplish today. That persistence changes everything. You're not starting fresh every conversation. You're building into actual relationship with software. Microsoft's calling it the evolution of what they tried with Cortana back in 2015. But let's be honest. Cortana was clunky. Voice assistants a decade ago felt like shouting commands at a confused robot. Miko feels different because it listens, processes tone, and adjusts. If you're frustrated, it picks up on that. If you're excited, it mirrors it. That emotional feedback loop is new territory. Jacob Andre, Microsoft's VP of Product and Growth, said Clippy walked so we could run. And he's not wrong. Clippy was annoying because it guessed what you wanted and interrupted constantly. Miko waits. It observes. It only steps in when you engage. That shift from reactive to responsive is subtle but massive. There's also a feature called Learn Live Mode that turns Miko into a Socratic tutor. Instead of just answering your questions, it guides you through problems with whiteboards and step-by-step visuals. Imagine prepping for an exam and having an AI that doesn't just tell you the answer, but walks you through why the answer works. That's genuinely powerful for students, language learners, or anyone picking up a new skill. Mustafa Suleiman, Microsoft's AI chief, has been hinting at this direction for months. He wants Copilot to have a real identity. He said it will have a room it lives in, and it will age over time. That sounds wild, but it's part of a bigger push toward human-centered AI. Microsoft's betting that people don't just want tools, they want companions. The marketing reflects that shift. New Windows 11 ads are literally calling it the computer you can talk to. And unlike Cortana, which got shut down on Windows 11 after barely anyone used it, Miko's already showing traction. Microsoft even added Easter eggs. If you poke the orb repeatedly, something unexpected happens. Those little touches make it feel alive in a way that previous assistants never did. But while Microsoft's reviving old mascots with new tech, Google just made quantum computing actually useful for the first time. Their Willow chip, packing 105 qubits, ran an algorithm 13,000 times faster than the best classical supercomputer. That's not theoretical anymore. It's verified against real molecular data. The algorithm they tested is called Quantum Echo, and it simulates nuclear magnetic resonance, the same science that powers MRI machines. Modeling how atomic spins behave inside molecules is brutally complex. Classical computers struggle. Quantum systems thrive. Google's engineers manage to ping the qubit array and capture millions of effects per second without collapsing the quantum states. That's absurdly difficult. What makes this milestone different is the deterministic output. Quantum computing usually spits out probabilistic answers, educated guesses that need verification. Quantum Echo produced reproducible, usable data that matched molecular experiments directly. That verification step proves the chip isn't generating noise, it's generating science. Google's calling this milestone 2 on their roadmap. Next up is building fault-tolerant logical qubits, which would unlock long-term quantum computation. For decades, scientists have said practical quantum computing is just around the corner. This might actually be the corner. Meanwhile, Meta quietly dropped DocuSaurus 3.9, bringing AI search directly into documentation sites. It sounds boring until you realize how many open source projects rely on DocuSaurus. Now, instead of keyword hunting, you can ask questions in plain English and get answers pulled from indexed pages. The integration with Algolia's DocSearch 4 makes it seamless. Developers can upgrade with a single command, and the AI assistant goes live immediately. This ties into a bigger trend. AI isn't just for flashy demos anymore. It's embedding itself into the boring, essential infrastructure that keeps the web running. Documentation search, code completion, bug detection. The quiet stuff that saves hours every day. And while Meta's pushing AI into developer tools, Microsoft's AI chief is pushing back against adult content in chatbots. Suleiman said Microsoft absolutely won't build romantic or erotic AI companions, calling those features very dangerous. That's a direct shot at OpenAI and Elon Musk's xAI, both of which are moving toward adult-oriented modes. OpenAI just confirmed that ChatGPT will soon let verified users generate explicit content. Under age-gated settings, Musk's Grok already offers flirty companion modes. Suleiman's making it clear Microsoft won't go there. "That's just not a service we're going to provide," he said. "Other companies will build that." The stance highlights a growing rift between Microsoft and OpenAI despite Microsoft's $13 billion investment since 2019. Reports say OpenAI just signed a $300 billion computing deal with Oracle, one of Microsoft's biggest competitors. Microsoft's doubling down on Copilot, focusing on what Suleiman calls human-centered AI that avoids the risks of simulated intimacy. Mark Cuban weighed in, predicting the move will backfire hard. He thinks parents will abandon ChatGPT if kids can bypass age verification. Sam Altman fired back, saying OpenAI isn't the elected moral police of the world. The debate's heating up fast. Georgetown researcher Jessica Gillespie says OpenAI's caught between consumer demand and investor expectations. People want romantic AI. Regulators worry about the consequences. That tension between what sells and what's safe is defining the industry right now. So here's where we are. Microsoft's betting on emotional intelligence with Miko. Google's cracking quantum barriers with Willow. Meta's embedding AI into the developer backbone. And the entire industry's arguing over whether chatbots should flirt. The real question isn't whether AI can remember us, teach us, or show emotion. It clearly can. The question is whether we're ready for that relationship. Should your assistant have an identity? Should it age? Should it feel? Drop your thoughts below. And if this breakdown helped, smash that subscribe button. Things are moving fast, and you don't want to miss what's coming next. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.